Previously on Life is Strange.
Whoa! What did you find?
Rachel in the dark room. Over and over. That's it.
We can't trust anybody except each other.
You know more about her than me.
No. You and Chloe think you know more than anybody. Like all teenagers.
Oh, look. The Wonder Twins.
What are you doing in my dorm? You are so fucking dead!
Nathan is truly psychotic. I know he has something to do with Rachel missing.
Kate wasn't the first. All those binders are filled with other victims.
What are you doing here, Max?
Victoria has to be next.
What a lame gimmick.
Rachel, why is he putting her in the ground like that? Where?
The junkyard. Max, we have to find that spot now.
Oh. Your life is in serious danger. Nathan just texted me. He says there won't be any evidence left after he's done.
Oh God, Max, look. She's still there.
Oh, no. Chloe. Look how.
What the fuck?
Hey guys, it is John, and we are playing Life is Strange Episode 5. I'm so excited, we've waited so long for this. Actually, we've just waited since the end of Episode 4, but I am really waiting with bated breath to see how this turns out. I have my theories, but I'll shut up for now. Victoria?
Oh shit! Jefferson kidnaps Victoria too? This is so bad.
Alright. She's out cold, I think, but we at least have to try.
Victoria! Wake up! Wake up!
All right. Detach.
Help!
Somebody help me!
Of course. And right in front of me.
Oh, that's the cell phone.
Of course.
Okay.
And right in front of me. These straps are hurt.
Okay. I think we have bigger problems than your straps hurting.
God, I don't remember anything that happened.
Oh, look.
This must be the same drug Nathan used on Kate. Oh, shit. That's me. He took that shot last night.
We have to get it so we can travel back in time. Let's do it.
Finally, I'm free. Almost.
Wow, we're lucky that that happened. Otherwise, the game would end here.
I hate looking at myself like that. You'll pay for this, Jefferson.
Oh, so it's already happened.
I promised I would never go back in time like this again. But this is the only way.
Max, I have a feeling we'll be doing this a lot this episode.
This angle highlights your purity, see? The slightly unconscious model is often the most open and honest. No vanity or posing, just pure expression. Oh, Christ. Look at that perfect face. Hold that stare there! Stay still! Max! You fucked up my shot! But please don't worry. We have all the time in the world. For now, I knew you were special the second I saw your first selfie. Yes, I still hate that word. But I love the purity of your own image. Not like Rachel, who was always looking in the wrong places. Poor Rachel. Let me try this angle.
His voice acting is different.
Don't move! Oh. Much better. Thanks, Max. If only Nathan could see this setup. He tried so hard. But you can't just throw a few subjects around and expect a cohesive style or theme. But he had an eye for shadows, and an eye for a whole lot more, as his elite family will find out, along with Arcadia Bay. Nice. Good. Oh, those eyes. It's just too bad you're so goddamn nosy, Max. But this room is under 24/7 surveillance, so all I had to do was text you from Nathan's phone, and you fell right into my hands. You really should have focused on schoolwork, not private detecting with your little friend.
Chloe.
Chloe, right. Yeah, I'm sorry that I killed, that Nathan killed her in self-defense. But she had a troubled history, like most Arcadia Bay dropouts. Nobody will be surprised. Or care. Though I promise, people will care when you die tonight, Max. I wasn't lying when I said you have a gift. Okay. Now this looks good. Maybe a few more close-ups. Max, please do not move so much.
I need you posed and framed my way. Maybe a new dose will calm you down.
No. No.
Now don't move or this will hurt much. Stupid bitch! You just don't listen, do you? In fact, you never did hear much in my class. If you had, you might have seen all this coming.
I kind of did see it coming.
Damn, you are a fighter, though. I've had my eye on you, and I've noticed that you've been more fearless this week than maybe your whole life.
No.
Remember my number one rule. Always take a shot.
Did you just make a pun? I think you did. Mr. Jefferson, you should be ashamed of yourself. Not for everything else, just for that pun. That was terrible. Was this all just set up for that? Okay, so what did I change? The photos were ruined?
Oh, Jesus. I can't believe that happened. So sick.
All right, wake up, Victoria. I know we gotta look at that. Come on. What?
I'd really like to smash that fancy camera into Jefferson's face.
Yeah, me too, Max. Do you guys ever fantasize about inserting yourself into a narrative as like an invincible character that can just beat up the bad guys? Because I do. I would totally love to just come into something like this and just, you know, give Mr. Jefferson in a stranglehold and choke the life out of him or something. That got really dark, but you know what I mean.
Okay. I broke those vials when I kicked the trolley.
Yeah.
Wait. Jefferson couldn't handle stains on his photos. Good. Now I can use them.
Oh. Oh, these photos. That's where they came from. Gotcha. Victoria?
Oh, shit.
Yeah, we already knew that.
Victoria. Hey, Victoria. It's Max. Can you hear me?
Max. Oh, God. Where are we? Oh, what's happening?
You've been drugged like Kate and me. Do you remember how you got here?
No. I don't know. Wait, you warned me. You warned me about Nathan. Then I went to Jefferson for help and he was acting so weird. That's the last thing I remember. And I can't move my hands. Help me, Max. Please, I'm sorry for everything.
Listen carefully. Mark Jefferson kidnapped us. He's using Nathan as well. Jefferson is very dangerous, so we have to get out of here before he comes back.
Max, I just can't believe this is real. I don't want to die like this. I'm only 18.
All right. Victoria, I think you're more in a position to help me, because I think you might be more mobile than I am at the moment, but all right, let's just console her.
Hold on, Victoria. Nobody is gonna die anymore.
Max, what's going on? I thought you said Nathan was dangerous, but it was actually Mark? Mr. Jefferson?
I was wrong. I should have known that Nathan couldn't do all this on his own.
Do what? What's going to happen to us? Oh, please get us out of here.
I'm not going to let that asshole get away with this. I need you to be strong. I can't do this alone. We need to act while we're clear-headed. If he doses us again, we'll forget everything.
I'm not strong, Max. Look at me. Look what I did to Kate Marsh. Now she's in the hospital, and I'm here.
All right. This is not the time to wallow in self-pity. We gotta figure out a plan.
We're both here, okay?
I just can't believe this is happening. That Jefferson would do this to me, to us.
Victoria, we will find a way to escape. I promise.
Max, I believe you.
Okay, good. I'm glad. Now we'll travel back in time with this.
Oh, I'm definitely more awake in this photo. I could try this one.
And then in the flashback, we can travel back in time through another photograph. Right?
Please work.
Okay. Why does it distort itself? What's doing that? Hey, she has a butterfly on her t-shirt. Which, I have my theories about that butterfly.
I'm getting some spectacular images here, Max.
Oh good, I'm glad.
Yes, Victoria would kill to be in your place, but she doesn't understand our connection. You're the winner, Max. I choose you, your portrait.
Fuck you.
You're trying too hard. I know you're scared. You all have the same doe-eyed look when you wake up here, replaced by fear as you realize what's about to happen.
Mr. Jefferson, why are you doing this?
Oh, Max, I'm so glad you asked that question. Simply put, I'm obsessed with the idea of capturing that moment innocence evolves into corruption. That shift from black to white to gray and beyond. Most models are cynical. They lose that naivete. However, some Blackwell students carry their hope and optimism with them like an aura. And those lucky few become my models, my subjects.
Yes, you're a psychopath. And this is your last session.
Au contraire, Max. I'm so sane that nobody knows what's happening to you right now. As you can see, Sleeping Beauty here is too harsh for my gentle lens. And don't get me started on your late partner. I had enough of those faux punk sluts in my Seattle days.
Okay, which one should we choose? I think I'm gonna go with go to hell. Yeah!
Go to hell. You will for everybody you've hurt.
Unlike pure sweet Kate Marsh, I don't believe in that bullshit. She could have been my masterpiece. The world is what an artist makes it. And my muse...
blah, blah, blah.
Blah, blah, blah. God, I hate your voice now.
You might as well savor it, considering it's the last you'll hear. Oh. That struck a nerve. Your face changed color. Beautiful.
You will not get away with this. I want you to know that.
Too bad you already made a convincing argument against Nathan in the principal's office. Thank you so much for setting him up for me. I do know that the Prescotts are going to have a major scandal when the town finds out what their elite son has been doing for homework.
Interesting. I did accuse Nathan in that scene. You had the option of accusing Mr. Jefferson, but... from what I remember, a vast minority of people chose that because, well, there honestly wasn't a good reason to do it. You didn't have any evidence. Anyway.
You used Nathan.
I prefer the term manipulated. Like with an image. Nathan's was easy to twist around. I became a sort of father figure for Nathan. It happens often in teacher-student relationships. It was kind of touching for a while.
Did you tell him everything about your plans at Blackwell?
Don't be stupid, Max. I told him what he needed to hear. In return, I had access to the Prescott fortune. Who do you think paid for this glorious darkroom and equipment? How else could I get all these hip new drugs for my subjects?
Rachel Amber was your victim, not your subject.
Oh. Rachel Amber. That's the real tragedy. Nathan thought he could be an artist like me. Instead, the dumbass gave her an overdose.
Why, Rachel?
I don't have time to tell you everything. But she was special. A human chameleon, so many visual possibilities. We had a real connection.
Did you know she also had a connection with Frank?
Let's be honest. She was doing the classic bad boy thing. She was over Frank before it began. He just didn't know, anyway. Rachel is dead. But no tears, Los Angeles would have killed her anyway, so look at this as a favor.
You're evil.
Oh, I see. You're good, because you stopped your friend from beating Nathan up.
I cared more about Nathan than you did.
No, you didn't. It's just too bad that he fell in lust with Rachel. He actually thought he could mimic what I do with the camera and subject, like father, but not like son.
Where is Nathan now?
Dead and buried. After what he did to Rachel, I knew I couldn't keep him as a protege for much longer. Now the police will never find his body. Do you finally get it now, Max? I can't compromise my vision with amateurs.
You are an amateur. Look at the trail of death you left behind.
That's a fair point.
You can't blame all this on Nathan. I don't care what you do to me. You're gonna die, motherfucker. For Chloe and Rachel and everybody else.
I do love your spirit, Max, but you brought yourself here by your own choice. Anyway, I like my models to be seen and not heard. So I have to make sure there's nothing left behind of you. Okay. Now, let's see how these shots came out.
Okay.
I can see why your instant camera is so appealing. You don't need a computer to print your workout.
Yes, that's the only advantage. Oh, God. Content ID claim.
I have all those photos in my diary. This could be a way out.
So wait, what am I doing?
Oh, now this one. This is purity personified.
Give me a break. Give it a rest, Jefferson.
Okay.
Hey, wait.
Wait. Please, Mr. Jefferson.
Max, I would love to talk shop, but I really need to go over these pictures, especially while they're fresh in my mind. I think our session was a career high for me.
Okay, this isn't gonna yield anything new. That's something stupid to ask. I don't want to see the photos. We'll go with this one.
You still have my diary.
Don't worry. Nobody's going to read it. Thanks for reminding me. There's nothing more innocent than a teenager's diary. Oh, look at your selfies. What a waste of talent. Look at that shot, Max. You can do so much better.
Thank you. Thank you, Mr. Jefferson. If this was a Hearthstone match, I'd be saying thanks right about now.
Alone with a heart, a battered old heart.
Oh, wait a second. No way, this is from the beginning of the game.
I could frame any one of you in a dark corner and capture you in a moment of desperation.
Oh, shit!
I believe Max has taken what you kids call a selfie. A dumb
I'm
word
back.
For a wonderful photographic
trick. Right back where I started Max, this insane week. And nobody
course,
is going to hurt Chloe
know,
ever
the
again.
The portrait has been popular since the early 1800s. Your generation
they
was
brought
not
it
the
full
first
circle.
To use images for selfie expression. Sorry, I couldn't resist. The point remains that the portraiture has always been a vital aspect of art and photography for as long as it's been around. Now, Max, since you've captured our interest and clearly want to join the conversation, can you please tell us the name of the process that gave birth to the first self-portraits?
The Daguerrean process. Well, there it is. I really want to answer this. Let's do it.
Who cares? This class is hella bullshit.
I'll pretend you didn't say that and let you try to answer one more.
Sorry, there's no time left. I mean, your class is almost over.
Oh. Well, thanks for the warning, Max. So, the Daguerrean process made portraiture quite popular, mainly because it gave the subjects clear defined features. You can learn more when you finish reading the assigned chapters. Clearly, Max doesn't have the time.
Hey guys, don't forget the deadline to submit a photo in the Everyday Heroes
contest. Time to change time.
The winter to San Francisco, where you'll be feted by the
first. Let's make it real easy to capture Mark Jefferson.
And Alyssa, get it together. Taylor, don't hide. I'm still waiting for your entry too. And yes, Max, I see you pretending not to see me.
Bastard.
Yeah, what a douchebag.
I have to warn David about Jefferson and the dark room.
Oh, that's a good idea. We should do that.
I hope I still love photography when this is done. Don't confuse the art with the artist. Bastard.
Yeah, I think it's been tainted for you, Max.
This diary literally saved my life.
Yes, it did. All right, so not to recap what I said in episode 4, or I can't remember if I said it in the video or just in the comments, but we're going to end up back in that bathroom where we first saw the blue butterfly, and that's where the final scene of the game is going to take place.
Did you know someday your pictures would actually alter time and space?
That's my theory, at least.
All I need is David's number, and Jefferson is one text closer to life without parole. I've got a ton of Blackwell brochures, so I hope David's number is in there.
Thank you. Let's do it.
I should be able to track down David's number from the school pamphlet.
For over 100 years, Blackwell Academy has been an academic oasis for art and science, with diverse students from around the world seeking to change the world and their communities.
Give it a rest, man.
Mark Jefferson. After blazing a trail in the world of 1990s style and fashion photography, Mark Jefferson always knew he wanted to share his vision and inspire others. In the late 2000s, he took a well-publicized detour into teaching around the country, inevitably ending up in a permanent position at Blackwell Academy. Mr. Jefferson's classes on art and photography are some of the most popular in the school's rich history, and his students will certainly go on to inspire others with their own vision.
Found you.
Oh, there it is. 555-630-8243. All right. Let's do it. Who are these other people? Well, there's Samuel. I know him. I like Samuel. And Samuel likes Max. All right, let's do this.
For once, David, I'm praying you'll overreact to this as much as everything else. And take Jefferson down fast.
Why would I rewind there? Mr. Madsen, you're after Rachel, Amber. Mark Jefferson is guilty. His dark room is under the Prescott's farmhouse. You know the location. He's sick and dangerous. Stop him.
You want maybe, me to enter the contest, asshole.
Maybe go into more detail? I don't know.
So maybe I'll be going to San Francisco. And Jefferson, you'll be going to prison.
I mean, it's a good plan, honestly.
The past within the past. Am I pushing myself too hard?
Yes, you are. We know that.
It doesn't matter, Victoria. It's nice to know how you really feel.
My phone is dead, and I'm barred. Time to bust out my... What? My posy? Alright, Victoria, that is the worst pee I've ever seen. But anyway, why not give up the word for the image? Because I suck, but Mark Jefferson rules. Everybody in here loves him, but he only seems to care about Max Seth. I want to hit her, but she wouldn't care. And there's a sin, Vic. Get over yourself, eh? Sorry, I had to. Okay, anyway, Did she just... Wait, what?
I'm happy to fix it, so you'll be here to get your fancy camera, Victoria.
With all the speed and power expected from a new greenlit, this GRLT-64S is packed with expanded features and manageability. It shoots what you want, where you want, straight out of the camera. JPEG images already have a superb quality, including a new level of depth, sharpness, and malleability.
Malleability? Really? Alright, I guess it is $5,300. So Victoria just left... She just left her tablet sitting on the desk? And her camera? And her diary? Wow, somebody must feel secure here.
Not impressed anymore.
Well, me neither. I have a tripod almost exactly like that.
If only I could tell the whole class about Jefferson and watch him squirm.
I mean, you could.
But I better let David take care of everything.
You could, and you could then rewind time. But I understand that you don't want to do that.
The 90s are over for you, asshole.
Yeah, it's true. Is grunge dead? Okay. Let's see. We're going to talk to Kate, of course, but...
Now I wonder how many victims Jefferson has left behind in his career.
Probably all of them are victims.
I can't blame the cameras, but... I just think of Jefferson using them.
No, he has that weird one with the... It looks like a video camera.
Oh, Rachel. I'm sorry.
I have a feeling Rachel is alive, but anyway.
Poor Kate.
We're gonna comfort her.
Hi, Kate.
Oh, hey, Max.
Kate? Listen to me.
I am.
Always remember that you're not alone. I've got your back no matter what happens. So do a lot of other people. We all care. We're all here for you. You need to know that.
Max, that makes me feel so blessed for the first time this week. I don't know what to say.
That's okay. Neither do I. Maybe we could both use a hug.
Yes, yes, hug! Ah! I love Kate!
Thanks. You always know the right thing to do.
Well, it helps to be able to rewind time. Alright, time for, whatever this is.
There's still some beauty left in Arcadia Bay. I still feel like the lighthouse is calling out to me.
Here's that camera.
I'd like to bust this up right now.
Yeah, I just get a new one.
I can't go past these photo boundaries, so I need to fix everything from here.
Photo boundaries? No, I was just looking. I wasn't gonna go through it.
Victoria, I'm sorry you have to stand next to that psycho.
Let's stand next to him.
I see right through your bullshit, Jefferson. Everybody else will too.
Give photo?
Mr. Jefferson, we need to talk.
Can you see I'm talking to Mr. Jefferson now?
Yes, I see. But maybe you shouldn't.
And why not?
Hold on, Victoria. Are you okay, Max?
I will be when Victoria understands that hiding behind a screen, posting videos of people is... incredibly cruel and unfair. You're smart enough to know how easy it is to hurt somebody, to destroy their life. I just want you to think about how much it would hurt if somebody did that to you. You can always make the right choice, Victoria. I know you've got a good heart. I've seen it.
Listen, I didn't...
You don't have to explain. There's no reason for you to be so insecure that you can't be happy with your own talent. Wouldn't it be better to lift people up than to bring them down? You could inspire people.
Okay, I don't know what you're talking about now, do I, Mr. Jefferson?
I think I should stay out of this one, Victoria.
Then I guess I'm done talking.
And that's okay, too.
That was kind of random, Max. What did you mean?
Here's my photograph for the Everyday Heroes contest.
That was easy.
No. It wasn't easy at all.
Well, I can't prejudge yet, but I'm very happy you decided to enter. That means a lot to me. And Blackwell, the first step for any artist is to put themselves out there in the world without fear. To be innocent.
Or guilty.
Well, thanks for the photo, and maybe both of us will be jet-setting to San Francisco this Friday.
Or maybe only one of us will be going.
Don't be so modest, Max. Anything can happen in a week.
As you're going to find out, Mr. Jefferson.
Oh, wow. Okay, so that was Rachel's body. In the last episode, a lot of people theorized that that was Nathan's body, but it's clearly not now. I was not one of those people, by the way. Alright, so Chloe's alive again. It's good, I'm happy, it just kind of pisses me off that they keep doing that to us. Surprise, Chloe's dead, except not really, because Max changed time again.
Whoa.
Okay, you're okay, Max, you're safe. On a plane.
Wait, why are there still those photo boundaries?
I hope I did everything right this time. Good work, David.
Man, this must be a hard week for Principal Wells. Holy shit, you rule, Max. I am so proud of my superstar.
Oh, you're alive. Oh, you're alive. I did it. I fixed everything. Wowzer.
You just had to fit one last wowzer in there, didn't you, Max?
It's so weird to be in between realities. Everything is out of focus and in the distance.
Yeah.
Please shut off your phone.
What? What is going on behind us?
I'm so stressed, but I'm so excited too.
Isn't that cool that planes have that now? You can just look on a screen right in front of you and see where you are. It's awesome.
I have to admit, I love being called an artist.
The Zeitgeist Gallery presents Everyday Heroes! Display and artist reception!
Zeitgeist Gallery! Oh my god, get over yourself!
It's the beginning of the end for Jefferson and the Prescotts.
Two Moon Diner? Amid all the environmental chaos in Arcadia Bay, such as the unseasonal snowfall and beached whales, some residents reported seeing two full moons last night around 8 o'clock p.m. Witnesses claimed the double moons were clear in the night sky until clouds covered them up shortly after they appeared. No cell phone or video footage has surfaced yet, which has led local meteorologists to believe that imaginations are in overdrive due to the recent eco havoc. Blackwell Security uncovers bunker and scandal. Acting on a series of tips from David Madsen, head of security at Blackwell Academy, police officers descended Tuesday on a bizarre underground chamber allegedly used by teacher Mark Jefferson and student Nathan Prescott to drug, kidnap, and photograph young women. Although there were no signs of physical or sexual assault on the victims, the disturbing revelations have sent shockwaves through the tranquil city of Arcadia Bay. Even Sean Prescott, the most powerful businessman in the area, is under investigation for his role as owner of the farmhouse where the high-tech darkroom studio was located. So, why is there a space here? I guess they used justify. Typical rookie mistake.
Aw, I haven't seen Hot Dog Man in forever. Chloe and I used to totally play the video game and watch him all the time. When we were innocent.
Please fasten your seat and stow any electronic gear until the plane is on the ground and at the gate. Thank you.
Wow.
For starting our descent.
That was an aggressive pilot just now.
San Francisco with clear skies and cool 60 degrees.
He was giving us a hardcore lecture.
Thank you very much for choosing Pacific West Air. Come fly with us anytime.
I don't think so. I'm hoping these airline seats get smaller so I won't have to fly at all anymore.
So, did Life is Strange make up... Did they create a fake mascot so they can make a fake pop culture reference? That is hilarious.
And all over the news. Eclipse, dead whales. Some people in this coastal town saw two moons. NASA's investigating it too.
Be careful. I'm still between realities. And I can't focus on this one for too long.
Well, right now, I'm focusing on that dude's nose stud. And you don't see a lot of dudes with nose studs. I'm not fashion shaming, I'm just saying.
I bet this is a nice break for Principal Wells. After all the damage control he had to do this week at Blackwell.
Yeah, a nice break. A nice break. With that newspaper right in front of him.
How did you sleep?
Hope I wasn't snoring out loud, Max.
Just a bit.
It's been a tough week at Blackwell. So I hope you'll forgive me. Between Mr. Jefferson and Prescott's, things have been hectic, to say the least.
I totally get it, Principal Wells.
That's a smart way of telling me to stop whining. We are proud of you for representing Blackwell at the Everyday Heroes Contest. I know I'm not exactly the guy you wanted in San Francisco, but we all want you to have a great experience here.
I already am, and we're not even there. Oh, Christ. Another nosebleed? Max, you're not just screwing around with time.
Don't say it. Oh, I thought she was gonna say time is screwing around with you. But she didn't. Max, are you wearing a dream catcher for a necklace? I don't even know what to say.
San Francisco is so cool. And this gallery is huge.
So is the buffet. If an event skimps on the food, you know it's a bad event.
As long as I don't have to eat any caviar.
This is your day, Max. You can do whatever you want. I hope you take advantage of your status and talk to as many influential people here as possible. Work the room.
I don't know. I feel so weird, like I'm a little kid hanging with the adults.
Max, after this week, you are certainly not a little kid anymore. In fact, you're a noteworthy adult being honored by your peers. Now you have to start acting like the photographer you want to be. Hell, I wanted to be in charge of a big school someday. So I started taking charge of things when I was young. Ask my poor classmates. Max, I'm gonna eat up that caviar so you don't have to. Better get in there and start schmoozing. You know, I won't always be here to take charge. But you come talk to me whenever you want.
Thank you for your great sacrifice.
After everything that's happened, this should be the least scary thing you've ever done.
Max, leave it to me. I know how to schmooze with these guys.
Wow,
had to do it many times.
You did it. Somehow. Right there I am. Along with all the other winners. I should say artists instead.
Yeah, watch Rachel Amber be on here. That'd be a twist. What is a hero? The Zeitgeist Gallery is proud to be a participant in the 2013 Everyday Heroes National Contest, a showcase for today's future stars of photography. The winners, chosen by prestigious teachers from art schools and programs across the nation, reveal imaginative skill and heartfelt awareness which highlight the casual heroism of those who may never appear on the news. I'm not going to read the rest of that because it's pretentious. All right. We're going to work our way from this corner to the opposite. Go. This is water. Actually, that's a Walt. It's a Walter.
I need to drop some serious cash in there.
Donations go straight into community arts programs. Give the gift of art. All right. I don't think you have any money, but...
I wish I had time to go see those murals here.
Is that Chicken Little?
The Zeitgeist Gallery does have a cool history in Frisco. San Francisco.
I was about to say, Frisco is a suburb in DFW. Let's talk to this pretentious person.
I never thought I'd get to speak to a gallery receptionist about my own work. Nice.
All right, don't freak out about the receptionist.
Why, good morning. You must be Max Caulfield. Congratulations for your Everyday Heroes photo. The exhibition is quite impressive, especially with your entry.
I'm over here. You didn't even look at me.
Wow, sir. A Danny Lee article.
Who's Danny Lee? I left my art in San Francisco. Yes, I was born on a BART train. Literally. It's a long, amazing story that I won't repeat here. Drinks are required for that one. Here's to Mom. Then I explain my obsessive love for the Bay Area and its outposts of artists and dissidents. Despite the rampant gentrification, artists and creators thrive regardless of socioeconomic pressures, because that's what they do. Alright. Seems like Danny Lee needs a proofreader. Galleries such as the Zeitgeist and Milkovich Fashion have engaged with the diverse community and practice what some patrons only preach.
I wonder how it is to live in a submarine like that.
Probably sucks.
It must be really claustrophobic.
Yeah. The hunt for the real October. Okay.
The revolution will not be televised.
Stop the startups. How many more shops and residents have to be driven out of their lifelong homes by the latest boutique cafe or overpriced theme restaurant? The tech heads that have enslaved the city need a lesson in transgression. Join us this Saturday to begin the end. Error, error, error. You know what? Fuck you. Startups are good. You should be rallying against the corporations that control the country. Whatever.
I love how much cool art is going on all over the Bay Area. Unlike Arcadia Bay.
Learn the craft and history of the Shambhala. Weekly classes with teacher Charles Ellick. Contact Zen is When at universal.ex. Zen is When.
Some mysteries should stay that way.
Oh yeah, this thing. 3-hour tour of the Bay Area coastline. Visit ancient burial and ceremonial sites. I think this is the second reference they've made to a 3-hour tour from Gilligan's Island.
Holy shit. This flyer was designed just for Chloe. I wonder if I'm ready for the mosh pit.
All right. One, you're definitely not. Two, how was this designed for Chloe? Just because it has a skull on it?
But what would I wear?
Nigel's Samhain Druid Festival. All right. Here's a tip. Never go to any party that doesn't have an end time. It means they don't have a plan.
How fun. Yes, Warren would definitely go ape over this show.
It means they don't know how many people are coming either. Which means nobody's going. How are you supposed to pronounce this? Zitian Davin? Industrial apocalyptic paranoia led to the birth of world dystopian cinema. Alright, I'm already bored. Of course it's $6.66 at the door. Whenever I'm not sure how to pronounce an X, I just assume it's a Z.
I heard Mark Jefferson was supposed to be here tonight.
Not anymore.
That was so shocking. I have one of his monographs too.
Hold on to it. His work is gonna be worth serious cash.
Where's your nose ring, bro? You guys were sitting right behind me at the... And you sound different, too.
Are you Max Caulfield? Bravo on your entry.
I'm over here.
I'm the art critic for Iris N Magazine, and we would love to include you in a piece about future trendsetters in photography. I'll send you the details this week, if that's okay. Congratulations for your piece.
Okay, she didn't take the picture, I did. I just thought I would clarify that.
Not my style, but... The neon is a nice representation. Oh, shit. Pretentious alert.
I'll be honest, I don't get this.
It's great to read all these comments. Even the mean ones.
Mean ones? Let's read them.
So inspiring. Not as good as last year's show.
Totally makes me want to start taking photos. The future of photography starts here. Lisa Simpson's, all right.
These heroes chose the path of least regret. A great example of total surveillance. Their 15 minutes are almost up.
Thanks, this is so nice. Inspiring stuff. All right, Steve. Of course you signed it John Doe. You wanted your anonymity to make your troll comment.
Look at this print. The depth of field, the colors. Look at the bokeh shape. This was definitely shot with a medium format camera using a Leica 35mm lens.
All right.
That one is kind of silly.
What? This is cool.
I would love to have this on a shelf someday. I like. But imagine how much time it takes to make one sculpture.
A lot more time than taking one photo, to answer your question. Not that I'm like dissing photography, just saying. Hi, woman.
Aren't you from Blackwell Academy? I wanted to go there, but I didn't get in. They have such a cool program. I bet you're learning a lot.
Once again, standing right here. All right, so I guess this is the black and white section. Monochromatic, if you will.
Like, I do not understand art.
Then you are in the wrong place.
Champagne makes me think of me and Chloe getting busted with that wine.
Busted, huh?
I know it's kind of simple, but I find this haunting.
Right? The instant print makes it look timeless. Nostalgic melancholy. A teenage girl.
Who's the
artist? I think it's for some contest.
That's cool. Seems pretty mature.
That's all right.
Oh, hey, you're the one who entered the self-portrait.
Yes, I'm right here.
Actually, do you call it a selfie? Anyway, I was very impressed about how you subverted it to make all of your photo subjects the focus. Oh, very smart.
Thank you. You should be ashamed that I had to walk in front of you for you to talk to me. I'm not really impressed so far.
I guess I have to get used to the idea of fancy food I don't want to eat.
Yep. The tinier the food and the bigger the plate, the fancier it is. Where did he just take that from? What? Did you see that? He just created food.
How do these galleries afford to rent here?
What was that little pirouette move you pulled? All right, I have no idea what's happening in the upper right. The lower right's pretty cool. Okay.
Usually these kind of contests, they put me to sleep, but I like how this show is about specific actions, you know, not just abstractions.
Hey, I'm over here.
Some unique stuff this year.
Who are you talking to?
This makes me feel so sad, like I was back in high school.
Okay. Oh, this is pretty cool. It's crazy to think that arms like that actually exist.
I always get so inspired whenever I come here.
Wait, what? Aren't you the girl that doesn't understand art?
Hey, I love your shot.
Thank you.
I just wanted to say congratulations, and I hope you get a lot more attention.
Thank you. I hope you learn to talk to people, look at people when you're talking to them.
I guess everybody is a photographer now.
Okay. Wait. Aren't you the girl that was at the Vortex Club party and denied me entry to the VIP section? Well, you're a palette-swapped version. All right, this upper right one is really cool.
Well, I have to say, this is the best everyday hero show I've seen since it began.
Excuse me.
All the pictures say a lot about our times. Bravo.
You know, as a straight man, I've never understood the appeal of two women kissing, but that is just me.
Like, I do not understand art.
All right.
I guess everybody is a photographer now.
Oh my God.
Excuse me, I just wanted to tell you how much I loved your photograph.
Thank you.
I've seen a lot today, but there's something powerful and understated in yours. I can't wait to see much more of your work in the future.
Look at me when you talk to me! My God! Yeah, some of these are pretty cool, and some of these are just kinda... eh.
Hi, excuse me, you're Max Caulfield, right?
Yeah. Yes.
Sorry to bother you, but my name is Danny Lee, and I'm with the Brooklyn People's Herald. I edit their art section, and I totally dig your work. Now, I know the whole ironic selfie thing is kind of played out, but there's something timeless about your images, so I'd love to set up an appointment or interview with you when you get a chance. Here's my card. So great talking with you, Max.
You too, Danny.
I also like how Max has, like, little to no reaction to a lot of these.
Bad exposure, bad framing,
Bad picture.
Bad person.
Done this so much better.
You're terrible. Fuck you. Wait. Is that guy doing an over-the-shoulder ass glance? Alright, I guess that was worth photographing.
God, I love art.
Okay.
You must be the everyday hero from Blackwell.
Yes, I am.
My name is Lauren Francis, and I run the media department at Detroit School of Visual Arts. I'd love to talk about you being a residency next spring.
You're really close.
Don't say anything to Principal Wells yet.
Why don't any of these people look at me when they talk to me?
I wonder if I can buy these everyday heroes pictures.
I bet you can, for the right price.
Sorry, I don't know your name, but I saw your picture in the gallery brochure.
Thanks.
I just wanted to let you know how cool your entry was.
Thank you. I'd rather look at your feet, though. Oh, this is actually pretty cool. I didn't notice the leg. All right. Hey, it's that girl again. She just has blonde hair this time. Oh, there's my picture. We'll go there last. Let's talk to these people over here.
How much would you pay for that?
Hi. Oh, I can't talk to them. Okay, this is the worst one. I hate that they're trying to make their fake mascot a thing. Oh, this is really cool. Excuse me. Hey, it's a photogenic guy in the background. All right, time to check out my picture, I guess. Say it again.
Be cool, Max. Smile and don't say anything stupid.
It's okay. You don't need to worry about saying anything stupid around the girl who doesn't understand art.
Hi, and there she is to save the day.
Hi. You did it, Max. You're a real artist, at least for today.
Chloe!
Hey, are you okay? We lost you there for a second.
Your notes.
I'm okay. Jet lag. High altitude. Oh, you left the ringer off, idiot. Oh, come on. Please answer.
Max, holy shit, man, your vision. It's true. You saw the tornado. It's coming.
What? Oh, no. Chloe, where are you?
I'm so fucking scared. I'm by the beach.
Chloe, can you hear me? Hello? Hello? Oh my God. The tornado was real. Oh, I didn't fix shit. Chloe will die. Arcadia Bay is gonna be destroyed. There has to be a way to stop this. For good.
There is, Max. Principal Wells, fly me back to Arcadia Bay.
Mac, I do not understand art.
How much would you pay for that?
Oh my God. Oh, I can't sit there anymore.
No fucking way. Chloe can't die again. I have to save her.
All right.
Excuse me, I'd love to ask you a few questions about your work.
Not so now!
Oh, you're Max Caulfield, right? Tell me what kind of instant camera you use.
Can we talk later? Thanks. I literally do not have the time to deal with everybody.
Well, that took a little longer than expected.
Apart. What am I doing to time?
Alright, I already know what we gotta do.
I just have to make one simple change so I won't end up in San Francisco. Simple.
Yep.
Sorry, San Francisco. Chloe comes first.
Wait, what? Wait, what? We're back in the dark room?
What did you say, Max?
What? Jefferson should be in jail, not here.
Jesus. It's like you're back in my class. You're still spacing out. It might be cool if you took one of your patented selfies now. The transformation between the old Max and the new Max. Anyway, answer my question, please.
Eat shit and die.
Eat shit and die.
Good answer. Good answer. Hey, your nose is bleeding. Probably gave you too big a dose. Sorry about that, Max. But considering you're about to die, a nosebleed is a first world problem. Oh, I had to let Victoria Chase go.
You let her?
Don't be stupid! Okay? She's exactly where she deserves to be.
No.
Oh, as if you care. Your iris, that dilation like a shutter. The pictures you're taking of me now. Too bad you pissed away your gift. You could have won the contest, but you destroyed your own beautiful photograph. What a waste. Sorry, I burned all your stuff. I got a little carried away.
Fuck! He burned my diary.
Always.
That's why I'm still here.
Especially since you've developed from nerd to hero within a week. There's something weird going on with you. Whoa. Did you see how crazy it is outside? Like I said, something weird. There's that fear. Oh, Max, it's an honor working with you on these final sessions. I hope these images will be appreciated for what they truly capture. The loss of youth.
Oh my God, get over yourself.
At least, that's the last lecture you'll ever have to hear from me. And I promise you,
No more nosebleeds.
Mr. Jefferson, please, don't do this. You don't know what's happening.
Shh, 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 shh. Quiet. Quiet, Max.
Please, don't do this.
Oh,
I promise. This final dose won't hurt.
No, 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 no. There's gotta be something I can do.
What?
Is it David?
No, David, no!
Wait, what?
Jesus. David Madsen. He's out cold. Good. I always hated that fascist fuck. Everybody at Blackwell did, right, Max? Okay, let's try this one last time.
Okay. How
I
did...
I rewind all the way. I talked to Jefferson and helped set a trap.
How did ex-military security guard guy get his ass kicked by artsy fartsy over here?
And I promise you, no more nosebleeds.
Wait, hold on. Can I please ask you for one last request?
Oh, you got me, Max. How can I deny that face?
Yeah, okay. Okay, so... maybe if we ask for some music, he won't hear the door?
Could he... please, at least play some music, so I can drift away.
Even at the end, you're still a dreamer, Max. It's a nice trait.
Now I'm a little bit crazy. Oh, it had to be this song, right? All right. But I'm pretty sure I'm gonna stay screwy
instead, and I'm a little bit. What?
Wait, what?
No way, Jefferson.
Come on. All right. Maybe, is there something we can do here? Okay, no, this not. All right. Maybe not. Okay, so we have to have him hear the door, actually. Okay, so how about... we gotta get the syringe out of his hands. So maybe one last picture.
Would you... take... one last picture of me? I want to be your best subject.
I almost don't believe that, but I think you've finally learned from me.
Tab journal. Hang on, what? It didn't change, though. Okay.
I promise. This final dose won't hurt.
What? My plan didn't work. Oh, Warren!
David, watch out!
How? How did you know that?
Oh, what? Come on!
Jesus. David Metz!
All right.
David, watch out! Get the camera next to you!
No gun. No balls.
Jefferson, it's over.
You are not going to stop me.
Wait, what?
David Mattson. Of course. Well, this is what you get for playing cop. A real bullet.
I have a feeling we're gonna watch David die a lot here. Seems like Jefferson has a few backup plans.
David, kick that table!
Yes, sir!
What? How'd he get over there? David, he like teleported!
I always hated that mustache. You hated him too, Max.
Oh my god!
Jefferson, it's over!
You are not going to stop me!
Grab your gun now!
Got it!
What? How did he get to his before you did?
David Mattson, you are one stupid son of a bitch. So don't blame me.
Jefferson, it's over.
You are not going to stop me.
Oh. That's what we do? Okay.
Oh, Lord, Max. Are you okay? Are you all right? Can you move?
Yes. Thank you, David. Thank you.
Don't thank me. You brought me here. Let's wrap up this son of a bitch first.
You know, it's like I said way earlier in the series.
He won't be going anywhere when he wakes up.
David Mattson
going to prison forever, or worse.
David Mattson was onto this from the beginning.
Now it's your turn to be captured in a moment.
He just need a little help.
Save Chloe. He burned everything, including all of my photos. Warren, yes, I can use that picture he took of us. Shit, no signal. Thanks, Mr. Jefferson, but you won't need this anymore.
All right.
Good God. It's a studio.
I better go outside and call Warren. Oh, please answer.
Hold your horses, Max.
No more fucking guns. So gross. I wonder if he charged that duct tape to Blackwell. Scumbag.
What is this place?
Every song you hear in jail will be torture. You'll never be free again. Frank isn't a bad person, but he can't be in denial about the drugs he provided.
Well,
the Prescott's had to know about this.
I mean, yeah, this is their land.
Oh, Chloe. I'm gonna save you. For the last time. There's no way I'm leaving your necklace here.
I had no idea he was this sick.
Looks like Jefferson was planning a major security renovation with Prescott cash.
Straw dogs, home surveillance system, 6 pan tilt drone cameras, 3 HD TV monitors, multi-control deck. $5,000, man.
No one would have looked for Nathan's body with this.
I'm sorry you had to be here.
Jefferson had plenty of women who would have totally posed for him. But he didn't want to give his subjects a choice.
Like I said last episode, he doesn't want willing subjects.
All this expensive gear just for sick bullshit. Just looking at that makes me want to vomit.
No.
I want to burn all these photos. I hate looking at me like that.
What the hell is this place?
Oh, that's Victoria's bracelet. I bet Jefferson was going to use that to frame Nathan. Damn, Jefferson torched everything. Now the only photo I can get is the one Warren took.
It's a studio.
I can still feel those straps. Stop, Max. You're free. Jefferson looks so pathetic now.
The Prescotts had to know about this.
Take his picture.
David Madsen is on the case. He's still looking for evidence.
Let's talk to him.
David? Are you okay?
Look at this place. It feels like hell.
Jefferson was gonna kill me. Like he did to Victoria Chase.
Oh, no. I always suspected that son of a bitch.
Yeah. I know you did. I stuck up for you. In my commentary, at least.
I never did. Until too late.
You shouldn't have to suspect your teacher.
He wasn't a real teacher. He just wanted to lecture. It was part of his sick plans.
I wasn't surprised when you accused Nathan of drugging Kate Marsh. I thought so too. And Max, I treated Kate like shit. I know she's a good person, but I'm not. I hope I get to tell her that soon.
Me too. I think that would make her very happy.
I knew Nathan Prescott was a threat. I just waited too long to neutralize him.
Jefferson already did. They had some weird father-son thing going on. But Nathan killed Rachel, and Jefferson had to use him as a scapegoat.
That pervert was pulling all this shit right under my nose, too. I could have stopped him and Nathan if only I wasn't so stupid.
No. I told Principal Wells Nathan had a gun and almost used it. But he didn't want to believe me. I should have been more loud.
We all make decisions we regret. But I have to admit, I'm impressed by you. And Chloe. And your investigation. I had all the high-tech toys while you had each other.
Maybe she learned from you.
I think she only learned how to hate my guts. I'm sure you know I hit her the other day.
I know you're sorry.
I'm not gonna make any excuses for my behavior. I tried to be a good soldier, but I wasn't so great. I tried to be a good father, too, but when Joyce kicked me out, I had nothing.
I'm so sorry about that. I didn't want that to happen.
I should never have set up those surveillance cams. Who kept all those files?
I'm going to tell Joyce I was wrong about you. She does love you. It's pretty obvious.
I try not to use my service as an excuse, but it's hard to come home after war. Most people don't know or care what it's like. Except Joyce. She gave me hope. A new life.
And you saved mine. Chloe, she would be proud of you.
I just want to see her safe with her mother.
Oh, no.
I promised Joyce I would go see a family counselor. I'll start by apologizing to Chloe.
Oh, he doesn't know.
I don't expect her to call me Dad, but maybe she'll stop calling me Step Douche. So, where is Chloe?
Oh, fuck. We gotta do it.
David. Chloe is... dead.
This isn't happening. It can't. No, God. Not Chloe. Max, are you sure? Are you...
Yes, I saw her. I saw a Jefferson killer in the junkyard. Last night.
Last night? When I was feeling sorry for myself in my hotel room? I promised Joyce that I would protect her and Chloe. How can I face her and explain this? I never even told Chloe that I... God damn it!
You killed my wife's child, you sick fucker! And you took away my stepdaughter?
Do it.
David, wait!
Max, I'm sorry. I'm sorry you had to see that. What a mess. What have I done? All that time I wasted with surveillance. Chloe, I'm sorry. Joyce, I failed you. My family.
You didn't fail. You did your best.
Max, you better get outside. You've seen enough of this room.
David, thank you for saving me.
Again. I always lose.
Jefferson is dead now, but I can still bring Chloe back to life.
I'm glad I did it.
Hold tight, David. I'm going to fix everything.
Just wake up. Let this be a nightmare.
Took last night in the parking lot.
Yeah, but why? It wasn't that great a shot.
Yes, it is, and I want it. Where are you?
I'm at the Two Wells Diner. Pretty much trapped in here with Joyce thanks to this Armageddon weather. I'm expecting the ocean to turn red.
I'm on my way.
Come on, that's crazy. You can barely walk on the sidewalk outside. Seriously, Max, stay wherever you are. Don't think the storm's getting smaller.
That's okay. Me too. But it's not over yet, Warren. So hold on.
Trust Limbo? Is that like Rush Limbaugh?
And I'm the one trapped in this fucking radio station. Somebody get me the hell out of here now! Now, goddammit, how I pay all those taxes!
You have one new message. Message received yesterday at 9 p.m.
Max, it's Nathan. I just wanted to say, I'm sorry. I didn't want to hurt Kate or Rachel or I didn't want to hurt anybody. Everybody used me. Mr. Jefferson is coming for me now. All this shit will be over soon. Watch out, Max.